हेलो भरत, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन सर, हाउ अबाउट यू? थैंक
आई एम एब्सोल्युटली गुड, एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर सच ए गुड स्कोर. आई जस्ट सॉ योर स्कोर कार्ड एंड आई वाज रियली हैप्पी टू सी दैट. आई थिंक वर्बल वाज द ओनली एरिया व्हिच यू आल्सो मस्ट बी कंसर्न अबाउट इट, राइट?
यस सर, यस सर. आई वाज एक्सपेक्टिंग अराउंड 30, बट टू थ्री क्वेश्चंस आई गॉट इट 21 एंड इट इवन स्केल्ड डाउन टू 18.
ओह, व्हिच स्लॉट यू वर इन?
स्लॉट 2 सर.
Okay, slot 2. So in slot 2
overall
also,
scaling was I got 8 marks above what I scored.
Okay,
but I lost 3 marks in verbal only. Means
in
I got some
inventor.
Around, yes sir, 5 marks in LRDI was bonus in normalization, and in around 6 marks in quants.
Oh, I was in the first slot, so I remember that for us, for verbal, our score actually increased a bit. And in DI, it decreased by 4-5 marks. In Quant also, I got a bonus of 4-5 marks. So that means that in slot 2, verbal was slightly more easier with respect to slot 1, right?
It was easier, but I more confusing between two options. Many questions were like that. Like, we could solve, but at last, we were stucking up between two options. Like, which to choose, which not to choose. Like, more of the questions were like, which one will be false, like that. So it was a bit tough. It was a bit tough.
Even I found it quite confusing this year. You're right. Okay, great. So I just want to know, Bharat, first of all, that when did you choose MBA as a career? I mean, and when did you start preparing for it? What was that particular moment when you thought that, okay, I have to do MBA now and I'll start preparing now?
Nothing special, sir, but CAT was in mind from inter days only. Like, CAT is like a strong area because quants was there, LRDI was there, and when I used to solve some puzzles,
okay,
it used to be a free flow for me. Like, without preparation I can do it. I have that confidence. So that when I was thinking about career opportunities, MBA wasn't secondary, but IIMs was main target, sir, because we will get the more exposure to the outside industry.
Right,
that's
right.
That's the main aim, and it the entry is through CAT, so I felt like ye to hum, we can do it like that. Like, it is
doable.
bit easier than all other opportunities. Like,
right.
GMAT will be having 50% of the English and 50% of quants, whereas here you can have 66% in your hands. So I felt like CAT will be more on my side than GMAT, so I went for CAT, sir.
Okay, and what is your academic background? I mean, what have you done before this in graduation?
Now I am in fourth year, sir, graduation, bachelor's in engineering, electronics and communication engineering, Osmania University.
It's in Hyderabad?
Yes, sir, Hyderabad.
And you belong to that place only?
Yeah, yes, sir, Hyderabad.
Oh, that's good, that because the college is in your own city, so nothing like that. And it's a good university, what I've heard of.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and being an engineer, you are saying because you are more comfortable with quant and DI, so you thought that because 66% of that would be in CAT and probably not that good in verbal, therefore you thought that CAT will be giving you an edge over the other exams, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and the final score actually shows this, that your overall
yes, sir.
Percentage
like,
actually because
my main aim was overall 99% should be crossed with quants and DILR score, and verbal will be add on for 0.5 percentile. This was my main aim and strategy for the exam.
Right.
That made me more easier because verbal was tough. And I didn't lose my composure because of that. Because I know that my overs are coming in the next slot. So that I can score more. You can see that more than half of my score comes from quant only. Like around 70 in quants, 134, 135, means more than 50% from quants only.
Oh, great.
So,
great.
Means like quants is on the third slot. But I could have, I know that verbal was gone, LRDI is bit okay, but still I could solve with the same temperament is because I have the clarity, and I know that if verbal is going, I know that quants is there, and I did it in quants. Like, you should have the clear clarity, and even LRDI was a bit tough. Even when you get the toughest questions, you should be so clear that it is tough for me, then it is tough for all. You should remember that.
Absolutely.
Like, if it is tough for everyone, maybe mostly can solve one question, but you are on the better side so that you can solve at least two questions. So, even you are solving two questions, you are getting one question more. You should think like that and you should do like that. Because if you lose your temperament, then exam is gone, sir. That's guaranteed. So, maintain your composure until last minute. Like, I attempted 25 questions out of 26 in quants. And last question, it was like 10 seconds I was supposed to answer, but time was over. Means like, that you can understand that even if you not do well in one section, you should get ready for the other section so that you can cover up the lost marks there, so that you can have the good percentage. That is the main idea.
You got the right nerve of care that your temperament should be good to do it actually. It is more than the concept that temperament is actually required, that you do not lose confidence. Because I've seen many students losing confidence after, okay, my LRDI was so bad. So at the end of it, so they just do bad in quantitative ability as well because of that, even if they are good at it. That generally happens. That's great. So Bharat, if I can ask you, so what was your preparation strategy for all these subjects? I mean, how did you prepare for, because as you said that you were already good in quant and LRDI and slightly weak in verbal ability. So how did you prepare for them?
The main thing I did was attempting previous question papers, and in grade up you will get some bites, sir, like quants sections like that. I used to solve them, like they push notifications used to come and I used to solve them. I mainly focused on previous year papers, sir, because more or less the paper will be similar to it. Like in quants and LRDI, it will be in those range only. So I used to, before I didn't have any preparation because max was always 10-pointer, sir. Always 10-pointer. So I didn't feel much preparation is needed. And even LRDI is like, if you can, LRDI is more like data interpretation and logical reasoning. Data interpretation, though, from data you can calculate it. It's more like quant only. The LRDI section will be more or less like, you will be having all the permutations and combinations. You need to eliminate the wrong ones. So I felt like nothing more like preparation. I started with the giving previous year papers, sir. Like I used to give 1 hour constraint of time and I used to solve the sets and I used to check it with the key and I used to check it with the percentiles on online. It is available now, sir. I used to verify it with that and I used to see where my percentile is going. If it is going below 99, then I used to think where I did wrong, what should be the attempting strategy. From there only I learned some more or less. Coming to verbal, I didn't prepare much for verbal because I know that when I used to read also, I used to feel like it's not happening because I can feel that it's not in my way. It's better to see, like I used to see only previous year papers for that also, because it's more like reading comprehensions. I used to focus more. I used to read whole the passage twice. I am a bit fast reader, so I used to read it twice and I used to infer from that.
Okay. So basically, if I summarize it, so basically you are saying that previous year paper questions that helped you a lot, right?
Yes.
Whether
sir.
It is quant or LRDI or verbal ability. So that was the main focus for you.
Yeah.
And which is very good as well, because actually that is the most authentic source of questions that we have. So why to go for mocks or sectional tests? Because obviously the authentic thing which has already appeared in these exams. So nothing can be better than that. Right.
I think that giving mocks can deteriorate you, sir, sometimes. Like, okay. I suggest everyone to not take mocks seriously, just learn from the mistakes you did. And I suggest everyone to attempt all the questions in the mock. Mm-hmm. Because if you are stuck between two options, you should be prepared for how to attempt. Like, tukka bhi marega means educated guesses, you should be prepared for them also.
Right.
That will be more helpful. Sometimes you should go from the options also. Like answers will be there only so that you can substitute one by one and you can check it faster. Even if you don't know the actual ways. So you should be open to all and mainly focus on the basics, not on the formulae. Because many questions will be mix of topics. So if you go by formulas, if you start remembering all the formulas, it is very tough, because if you remember all the formulas of geometry and you can see in the paper, two or three questions were from the geometry. but the syllabus of geometry and the formulas in the geometry will be very high. So you should know how to do. And I would suggest that if any geometry triangle problem is there, you can just sides wala some question is there, just go with keeping all the sides equal, all the angles equal in the triangle, and check with the options. That will be more easier.
That's very important, Varad, because for most of the students, actually, they feel that this exam is also like that 10th, 12th graduation exam where you read a book, you read some formulas and do it. So these alternate things, these are also required, and probably these are more important than formula driven things. And this is what actually you went for, which is and therefore only success actually follows it, and it is quite visible by that. That's great.
Everyone can see that, because everyone will get more than 90% in mathematics until 12th also, but they cannot get 50% of the score in quants.
Why
everyone should think, well, why we are not getting? It's more like not the in theory exams, you should just write the theory and you have enough time. Here,
absolutely,
you need to adjust both of them. You are not expected to give the whole theory. You are just expected to get the answer.
Absolutely.
Some or the way you should get the answer. That is more important, I would say.
Absolutely, absolutely. So if I look at it, so basically your strong areas were quant and LRDI. So I can say, if I talk about your strengths, so the way we do a SWOT analysis for us, so a strength was quant and DI for us. As far as the weakness is concerned, I would say verbal was the weakness. So
yes,
is there anything specific that you did to overcome that weakness of yours? I mean, be better at verbal ability? Or you just thought that, okay, if I have other two sections, I can probably manage by doing decent, getting a decent score in verbal, and then I can get a good score overall?
I thought the second way, sir. I thought that around 30 to 40 marks in verbal would make my way easy, simply, because as I thought before, 99 percentile should be crossed with quants and DILR, and the additional 0.5, 0.7 percentile should be given by, what we'll say, verbal ability.
Right.
But
so
what happened in my exam was,
if
verbal,
I look at the scorecard, I think 10, 15 score more would have taken you close to 100 percentile overall.
Oh, yes, sir. I thought that, I said, no, sir, verbal will be, I thought even after giving the section, I thought that I will be getting 30 in the exam, and I should manage to score 100 in the next two sections, so that the overall score will be 130, 99.5 percentile will be crossed. Because even if the exam is for 228, you need to, I had a clear clarity that when the exam was for 300, the marks were around 150.
Right.
Everyone wasn't not able to score more than 150 mainly because of the time constraint. Means per hour you should get 50 marks to get 99 percentile. Means in this simple analysis, in 2 hours exam you should get 100 marks.
Mm-hmm.
If you get 100, you will get 99 percentile. It was around 102 this year after normalization. If you get around 100, you will get 99 percentile. More 10% marks will give you 99.5 percentile. So it's like 120 will be 99.5. It was, I already fixed that 120 will be 99.5. After giving verbal ability, I felt that 30 will be coming, around more or less 30 will be coming. I should score 100 so that 99.5 will be crossed, which is safe for me. Then I went with the same pace and I solved LRDI. I gave 19 questions and I got 15 correct, 75-80% accuracy.
Mm-hmm.
And after writing the section, I was feeling that 50 to aa jayega.
You got better than that.
No, I got some less. LRDI, sir. I thought 50 would be coming, around 50.
So
I got 45.
Got
Then I was like, LRDI mein 40, 50 tak aayega to you can hit easily 50. Like pressure was down, sir, because 50 was the target. As I am solving, the last 5-6 questions were solved in 3-4 minutes. Like in 3-4 means around 28 minutes I was solving the first 18 questions. Then I went for the next questions. I was thinking that 8 questions, 8 minutes wouldn't be sufficient. But I solved in the 3-4 minutes because the questions were easier.
Okay.
Generally, I saw in the papers also that last questions will be easier. Like in the papers, I saw previous papers, last questions will be regarding logarithms.
Okay.
That, but I was not confident because the questions will be jumbled. So I was not confident, but it repeated for me. generally, if you see any quants paper, last questions will be easier. Last 10 questions will be very easier compared to the all. Like, you can do 1 minute per one question.
And luck also favors the brave.
Luck favors the brave if you get it in the first 10, sir. Because if you get it in the first 10, in 10 minutes, you will get 10 answers and the pace will be changed, sir. Because absolutely, you will have the more time and more scope. Yeah. But I got it in the last 10. But as my max is good, I could overcome that.
Great.
That's
great.
It, sir.
Okay, that's a long-term strategy that we have discussed. So what did you do in the last 2 weeks before your exam? I mean, when the exam was just around the corner, 2 weeks are left. So what exactly did you do over there?
Last two weeks, I gave some two mocks, sir, in the second week. In the last 1 week, I just chilled, sir. My mother thought that, really, you are giving exam. She asked me, really. Are you giving exam seriously? On the day of exam, I am saying that I am going for exam. She is like, I don't think you will score well. She was like that.
So unless they see that exam anxiety on your face, they will not feel that you are going for an exam.
If anyone, more people can relate to me, if many people would have given JEE, where they would have felt that the anxiety levels will be very high, sir. In JEE, I gave, the anxiety levels were very high and the exam was gone, sir. Simply gone out of my hands. I was very tense. I started with math and I was unable to solve first 5 questions in 10 minutes. I was not getting the answers only. In mocks, I used to get around more than 100 for 120.
Okay.
Like, tension was on my head like that.
All the time.
It will be gone. And from there, I learnt and I did the same strategy, like not feeling nervous. Like, I gave it in first time. I got some 128,000 rank around in JEE. Second time, I gave without preparation after coming into my bachelor's. Without zero preparation, I saw some 2-3 formulas in physics and I went for the exam. I got some 17,000 rank.
Okay.
Means with 2 years of preparation, I got 28,000 rank with pressure. Without pressure and without preparation, I got 17,000 rank because
that
of my basis.
Anxiety actually impacts adversely basically on your score. Yeah.
Very, very adverse, sir. It can make a 99.99 percentiler to 80 percentiler, 75 percentiler also. It is possible, highly possible.
Right.
I think everyone should give JEE if they have max. Just give JEE with some preparation so that you will be prepared for other exams.
Okay, you'll get an idea about that. Okay, yeah. And how important were these sectional tests, quizzes that you appeared for? I mean, how important were these for your preparation?
They were very important, sir, because in sectional tests, generally we do make one mistake in some 7-8 questions. Like, around 87-90% accuracy, that one question is very important because you were able to do 7 correct means you have the ability to do the 8th one also correct. But you missed it because of some factor. It may be anxiousness or overconfidence, something, or some miscalculation, something. When you check out the answers, you would be feeling that I would be getting full on full. But when you check the key, you will be losing 1 mark. It generally happens 1 mark. You should overcome that. Like, sometimes it will be like overconfidence. Ye sab aa gaya to ye bhi aa jayega. Sometimes it will be like simple calculation errors, minus, plus, LCM, HCF. So you should make sure that how your brain is working and how you are doing the mistakes when you are getting the flow. Because let us assume that if you know the topic very perfectly from the basics, but you couldn't do the exam, it in the exam because of some silly mistake, then what is the use of knowing that topic very confidently? That's the main target.
So these sectional tests basically prepare you for all the basic mistakes that a person generally make. I mean, you get to know about them beforehand, before the paper, right?
Why? Because if you give the overall mock test, you will find many mistakes. Like around 30% of the paper would be mistakes. So it is tough to divide into what were your mistakes actually. But when you, in the topic, because it is more like CAT is not a one exam for 3 hours, but 3 exams for 1 hour each. So you should be prepared for that. So sectional test would be more helpful than the overall test, mock test. I would prefer giving sectional test over mock test.
That's a very, very good point that you have raised, that actually if a person look at it as 3 sectional tests of 1 hour each, rather than looking at it as a complete paper, even the guy would be high on confidence and probably they would be able to manage it much better then, you know?
I think that IIM should be somewhat lenient and give two interchange between sections also, so that we can score more.
Right,
because verbal would be
allow.
I would prefer attempting verbal for less time and give my time for quants and LRDI because I have more grip, so that I could score more.
That would, had that been the case, you would have been 100% LA today.
Maybe, sir.
great. And
but
and
I didn't think that I would be getting around 99.92. I was thinking that it would be around plus minus 0.1, around 99.97.
That's thought because it would of be verbal ability, basically. You lost some marks over there, right?
Yes, many were showing it was around 99.7 only. I was also thinking if I cross 99.7, it would be good. But when I saw the result, everything was up down. Like I thought 80 in verbal, I got 73. I thought 99.7, I got 99.92. Everything was interchanged. I thought
okay.
Like more. Where I thought more will be coming, I got less. Where I thought less will be coming, I got more.
Ultimately, anyways, it doesn't make much of difference. 99.92 or 95, they are almost the same. Okay, so when you looked at this new pattern of CAT, so I mean, how did you manage with this? I mean, what difficulties did you face because of that, or anything that was there to your advantage that you felt?
I felt it was very advantageous to me because in 40-minute section, people who are strong in their topics would feel it is easier because. Then the people who are not strong, because you will have only 40 minutes, but the questions will be more comparatively, the ratio will be more, and you need to be a bit faster. If you are strong, if you are strong in the subject, then you will get the more advantage over the other students. Like my approach was simple, that quants and LRDI I was strong and verbal I was weak. So I felt happy that number of questions in the verbal would decrease, so that others wouldn't score more, because if we had the 3-hour section, I don't think I would be getting 99.92. Somewhat less I would have got, somewhat less. I felt that when they said that 2 hours, then I felt very happy.
Okay. So it helped basically you.
Like, and it will be breaking everyone's. It will be breaking everyone's mock giving pattern and their strategies, which would help obviously me, because if many people go beneath you and you stand straight, then you will be having the advantage over the others.
That's a great point, Bharat. And you find this year's paper tougher than the previous ones? I mean, because you have appeared for previous year papers as well. So was it tougher than those or easier than those?
This is my first attempt, sir. But I gave
But you appeared, mocks. Like you said that you actually... Yeah. Attempted
I used to give in the whole
as well.
Yes,
so got an idea from those.
Like, it's like everything was verbal was a bit difficult for me. Then the other papers, like 2018 paper, was comparatively easy because I scored more in that. DILR and quants were easier than the last years. Easier, according to me.
Students will say you will always find them easier because that is a strong area, but for many of them it is not.
I felt that. No questions on geometry and less questions on, not even one question, I guess, on permutations and combinations would help anyone. I think would help anyone to say the paper easier than the last years, because permutations and combinations, you have larger scope of mistake, and geometry would deal with a longer process of getting the answers. So if when the questions from those topics decrease, the paper automatically gets easier, because arithmetic is, everyone can do the arithmetics and work time, so it's like easier paper than the last years.
Okay, great. And now one important question for us as an organization: how did GradeUp help you in all this preparation?
It's like the mocks of GradeUp and the tests were very good, sir. Like, if you see, I even prepare for the GATE exam. When I solve the questions, I used to see that the questions were, the quality of the questions was very good. Like, I used to feel that like these questions would be, never be coming in the exam, but at the end of the day, what it will help us, because it will test more concepts. Because if such kind of question is asked in the exam, almost all people would go wrong in that question, but we will have the advantage because we solve that type of questions. you can check even the free series of the grade up. The questions will be of very, 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 very good level.
Okay, great. Thank you. You're great.
The level so, of the questions.
Primarily the questions. And how about the lectures that you attended at grade up? So how were they?
It's like when you don't know anything, it's preferred to have a mentor.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you don't know the any topic, especially in quants, it's like more like you should learn first.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to have a better teacher, and grade up gives the top percentilers as the teachers. So there is no question of no need to ask how grade up does, because when the person teaching is already proved that he can do the paper, then mm-hmm. he's teaching means you should be able to do it.
So at least you can have that 100% confidence that whatever he is telling us has to be correct, because he himself has done it. That's right.
Yes.
And what feature in grade up you like the most? I mean, any specific thing that you feel that, okay, this is something that helped me the most and I like it the most?
To be specific, their analysis on the paper, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Like how to attempt, how not to attempt, because just after the exam, grade up will be starting their sessions, how was the paper, and even after the post answers response sheets, they will again conduct it. When mm-hmm. you are going for any exam, strategy is most important, like how you should plan the exam and how should you attempt, like how should attempt this section, how should you attempt this section, where you would stand if you score this much. So when you get with any like grade up, you will be having clear cut idea that this much score will be of this much percentile. That's what you want at last of the day. So when you are seeing the paper, you will know the difficulty of the paper automatically, and you can just say that like this pay this percentile hoga.
Mm-hmm.
Like it should be around that. Like I said that around 110 would be 99, around 100 will be 99, around 120 will be 99.5. It was almost there. Like 99.5 was below, 100 was, like you can just say by seeing some analysis, because when you see more analysis, you will know that how this analysis will be. You can predict to more extent.
Right. We also keep telling our students that probably writing these mocks probably is not that important, as important the analysis part of it is, that how to do the paper and what all mistakes a person can make, where are you making mistakes. So exactly that, we also feel that's a very important part probably. So we also try to put it in the most precise manner such that it is beneficial for all the students. So that's great, Bharat. And any advice for all the students that you want to give? I mean, for all the students who are appearing for CAT 21.
Don't panic. That's the main important thing. Around 190,000 applicants, only 1900 are making into 99 percentile.
Mm-hmm.
Which is around 16 questions, 15 questions would be enough. Like 16 questions to 17 questions per hour would be enough. Like you will be having more than 3 minutes to solve a question. Means like one DLR set, you can give 12 minutes. So don't panic. You can easily cross the minimum barriers so that you can score more.
Yeah, that's quite visible at your face as well. It looks like that you never panic in these situations, because you are looking so cool and composed, and I am sure that this is going to help you in your future as well, for sure. This property, this I would say virtue of you is definitely going to help you, and that's a very, very good piece of advice, Bharat. So
thank you
very much, Bharat. Thanks for all of this sharing of knowledge, and I'm sure this is going to be very beneficial for all the students as well. And I again congratulate you for the score and for all the future endeavors, and grade up is always there with you for any kind of assistance that you need from us.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, brother. Thank you very much.